Spencer is here for InsideTrackNews.com and DelawareSpeedway.com. I am with, panning out a little bit, you sort of see the car. It's resting right now. Jay Doerr, Pro Am Auto Division here at Delaware Speedway. We're talking about the Great Canadian Race. I mean, it's really sort of taken on a life of its own. I mean, this race, what it means to this speedway, I know how important it is. You're a guy that sort of, you know, have come into your own as a driver. You grew up here as a driver at Delaware Speedway. What does the Great Canadian mean to a late model competitor that runs here weekly?
Well, it is Delaware's event. It's the event of the summer. I mean, a lot of tracks run them at the beginning of the year. You guys up north there run them at the end of the year. It's our event, and we're really looking forward to it.
I mean, when you go into an extended distance event like that at Delaware Speedway, what are the variables? What's the strategy? I mean, you got to conserve tires and brakes. Is there more to it than that?
Well, it's the same as the APC Challenge has been all year. You know, we're running 100 lap races, and we've struggled all year with this new tire we're on, and we finally think we figured it out. We're one of the fastest cars when the sun's out, so our expectations and hopes are very high for the Great Canadian Race being run in the afternoon.
Now, you've won a race every year you've competed at Delaware Speedway.
Except one.
Except for one. What year did you not win?
I don't remember.
We are going to go back into the history books and check that out.
Yeah, yeah.
But 2014, you've not found victory lane yet. If you could do it at the Great Canadian Race, I mean, how huge would that be for this 43 squad?
Well, we're going to be digging even deeper tonight because we feel like we got robbed tonight, but that's for another interview. we're going to be serious. We're going to strip this thing down and really put some attention into it. We need to win a race this year. We can't have a second year without a victory.
I mean, it just feels as though everybody that runs that event, especially the Delaware weekly competitors, just sort of dig down and find an extra gear and just find that extra level of intensity to come out here and take their program to the next level. What do you guys need to do to sort of get to that level of intensity and be up there and racing with the guys that are perennial contenders like your Mark Watsons and your Matt Pritikos and your Jesse Kennedys?
I think we're there. I mean, like I say, we've been fastest car in practice here in the sunshine. Last week we were fastest car in the heat races. Tonight we were really fast in the sun. Our car's been fading when it gets dark. We're confident right where we are. And we're going to, like I say, go over this thing thoroughly and see what happens next 2 weeks, three weeks.
I know that it's not possible that the right people behind the scenes, the marketing partners, the crew, and just everybody that gets this car to the racetrack, thank the folks that really make it happen.
Yeah, Remax, Ron O'Brien, McRobert Fuels, Fast Signs, Once Upon a Child, my guys that work so hard. The Lawn Man, he came on a couple years ago. He's been awesome. I always forget to thank the safety crew. The safety crew here at Delaware is just awesome. I was on fire a few weeks ago in a bone stock, and they were to me, put it out real quick.
Every good story starts with "I was on fire."
Yeah, okay.
I was on fire a few weeks ago. Yeah, that's a good story. Like, that's, you go to a restaurant, sit down, and say, "I was on fire once." That's people will come and talk to you. It's a good story. Thank you so much for the time, man. I know you're on Twitter too, so what's the Twitter account?
At @Jay_Doerr.
And he says many witty things, so make sure that you follow him.
Cheers.
There you go. Jay Doerr here at Delaware Speedway. Come on to the Great Canadian and watch him go to